special. Okay, well, my dog, I have a Rottweiler, and he decided to play a little rough with me the other day, so he hit me in my eye, right in the middle here with his claw, and it cut my eyes, but I got it checked out this morning, and it looks like I'm gonna be okay, so I'm gonna be with a patch for a few days, so not looking too good, but.
I believe that the reason probably is because, I don't know, the way the music industry is right now and the rock scene is, at least in America, you kind of have to have a story behind you before you hit the road or you probably will go broke, you know what I mean? There's a lot of bands out there trying to make it, and I think that they wanted the album to see what kind of response we got off of it. And you know, I know all the guys in the band are really eager to go play now, but it's coming up real soon. The album's taking off. It's doing well, so. You know, we just want to have a little story behind us when we go out so at least people know about us before we go out and we don't, like, play for, you know, 10 people, which, you know, fun, but I mean, I'd rather play for, you know, a couple of people.
Yeah, it's also a question of just waiting for the right thing to come along. You know, we're not just going to take the first thing we get offered and jump on it. And we want the album to develop a little bit, like Sid said.
We've gotten great response from the fans so far. We got probably about 300 or 400 fan letters off of just some publicity photos before anybody even heard the record, which was really exciting for us. And the response has been really good on the record. There were a lot of people that were waiting for it and expecting it. We got a lot of good press before the record came out. And lately here, we've been, a lot of the little girls have put their phone number on the letter. And we decided last week that instead of writing them back, we'd call them. So we've been calling all the fans, and they really get a kick out of it. And just, you know, going, hey, have you got the record yet? You know, you need to go out and get it, you know. And they get some real excited, and they'll tell all their friends. So hopefully that'll do something for us.
And I guess we'll just keep doing that until it hopefully gets so out of hand that we can't do it personally anymore. I think for this band, it's very important, you know. I know that we just like to perform and you know, if you go to a concert and you watch, you know, the show, if someone's not putting on that extra show for you, you know, and then you might as well just close your eyes and go buy the record and just listen to the record. That's why they call it the entertainment business, you know. When you come to a Roxy Blues show, it's just, you know, it could turn out to be a three-ring circus, you know. That's the more going on, you know, just not a lot of gimmicks, just, you know, rocking and having a good time and making the people part of, you know, instead of getting up there and being stereotyped, you know. So we like to involve the crowds in our shows, and I think the live shows are a real important part of Roxy Blues.
Ready to rock and roll? Todd, one-eyed bandit. Show him your eye there, Todd.
Show the eye.
Rock and roll Japan! Ow!
So I hope they got all of
them. Ow! Ready to rock Japan.
Roxy Blue.
You're next.
We'll be coming to Japan soon.
Not only are those awesome,
green.
Have I heard an amp yet?
Hey, Matthew,
yeah.
Check it out.
Oh, it's working?
Yeah.
Everything's perfect?
Yeah.
Hey, Lance, who cares?
Knock it out. One, two, three.
Fuck him up! Fuck him up! Fuck him up! Fuck him up! Fuck him up!
Woo! You guys ready to stomp tonight? No. You guys ready to stomp? I tell you what, we're going to bring the roof down tonight, okay? We got a long night ahead of us, so you people drink up. And let's fucking rock and roll. Anybody out there ready to get bad to the bullet?
Well, we'll start here with my buddy Todd. Personalities of everybody in the band from my point of view. Todd is the Todd likes to take things on. He likes to be the ringleader, which every band needs one. He's the worrywart of the band. He's always worrying. He'll call me up, man. If everything's going great and there's nothing to worry about, he'll be like, man, dude, what's up, man? What can we worry about? What can we worry about, man? We gotta get on this, man. We gotta get on this. And he just keeps everybody on their toes, and you know that's his whole deal. You know, he's real strong personality. You know, it's not easy to forget when Todd's in a room. You know it. I mean, I don't even have to see him walk in. I can just feel it. You know, I start getting worried, like I've done something or something.
Oh, come on.
No. And Sid over here, Sid's the crazy guy in the whole bunch, man. He's today's been rather quiet. You never can tell. Sometimes he'll be quiet. Sometimes he'll be loud and boisterous. He's always out for a good time. You know, everything's fun with Sid. That's about it on Sid. But Josh down there now, the man with the shades on, giving the peace sign, he's a quiet guy. Sometimes, man, you can be sitting in the room and Josh will leave and you won't even know it.
He can be sitting at the same table.
Yeah, he's just real quiet, but just like that paper phone. And, you know, the thing about Josh is, though, he has multiple personalities. He's real quiet. He's a, you know, the soft-spoken guy in the band. Never any trouble, never causes any crap, never raises his voice. But when he gets on stage, it's like you can't even believe it's the same guy, man. He's just totally crazy. And as for myself, I don't know. I feel like I might be kind of the peacekeeper. I don't know how it ended up this way. I was the last guy to join the band. And whenever somebody wants to talk about something, they'll call me.
Well, also, Scotty T is like, he is the peacemaker, but he also is like the comedian of the band. I mean, sometimes he's like, everything's funny to him. I mean, even when, I mean, if I'm trying to be serious about something, it's still funny to him. So, I mean, it's cool. He keeps a little humor in the band. And it's like, really, all of our personalities are totally different.
Yeah, totally
different. But they don't clash, you know. It's really weird. But, I like these guys. Okay.
Yeah, they're all right.
I could hang out with them for another 20 years.
What? 20? Can we negotiate that?
Yeah, 7.
It has to be reversed. Yeah.
Now we're gonna go over here. This is Bill Street. We're gonna go over here where they play blues all day. They hang out, they pick, and they're killer. Maybe they'll even play something for us.
After all, this is the home of the blues.
This is the home of the
blues.
We're
gonna go over here where they drop change for these guys and see if we can get some extra cash.
Let's go see if they wanna be like on Japan television. Let's go find out. I guess they're done.
Right on.
Hope y'all enjoying. Hope y'all got some shots to take over there.
No doubt.
We gonna get a picture with
us. All right, great.
The blues man right here.
It's a blues man. Memphis, Tennessee.
Straight off.
People like this keep up the Memphis tradition.
Right here.
Japan, welcome to the blues.
Right on.
Yeah, we'll show you all the blues lovers. These people here, they come out like on the weekends to rock and roll.
Washington, D.C. There you go, Washington, D.C.
Well, she's from Washington, D.C., but we don't really, you know, we're from Memphis, so she really doesn't know what's happening.
I don't know.
These are just people like sit out here, drink beer, and watch the blues. Got great music. They're just done now.
We down with sake.
We down with sake. Yeah, you know.
Father of the blues.
We got him. W.C. Handy.
Handy.
He's the trumpet master himself.
A virtual one day,
pioneer of the blues is what he is.
Pioneer.
That's exactly what he is.
What if it was me?
He boldly went where no man has gone before.
It would be a statue.
Oh!
Dude, kick that trash.
Let's go see. We got here now. Oh, here we got color sketches. This is really cool. They do like
See, look here. They do like color sketches of people. Hey, let's embarrass somebody. Let's make them freak out while we're here. Look here, watch this. See, she doesn't even know she's going to Japan television right now, and she's being sketched. Isn't this great? This is Memphis. This is the Blues. This is great, yeah. Japan, there you have it. She's our model for the day.
Looks like
model for the day. Yeah, yeah. All right. This is like our typical corn dog.
This is the corn dog, man.
Corn dog.
This is a woman buying a corn dog.
This is a real Memphis, Bill Street corn dog.
Today, the menu where we shot the video.
This is where we shot the video right here.
Right across the street where it says Smithereens. That's the place that you see. You
can see our video.
Shall we?
Walk right this way.
This is the guy with the blue reel popcorn.
There he is right here.
Roxy Blue.
We own this place.
This is the place.
Talk about the video.
Well, we did the video here.
We actually did the video right here.
Looks a lot different when there's nothing set up. There's
no people here or anything, but you can get the idea.
It's really bigger than it looks.
Oh, this is our office.
Take it right here. This is where we all
start dressing. This is how we get treated when we come here.
Wonderful thing. Listen, you smell? That's Memphis Bill Street odor. That's great.
See these American made toilets.
American
made. This is what we prepared for the video.
Look here. American made toilets here.
Wonderful, huh? Okay, let's go.
Pretty soon, they won't be American made, though. This is the man who's famous for the Blue Ribbon popcorn on Bill Street.
Kentucky?
Here you go. Can we get a little Kentucky Blue Ribbon?
Yeah.
All right, let's get a little Blue Ribbon popcorn.
Yeah.
Blue Ribbon fine, ready Kentucky hybrid popcorn. Oh, this is hybrid popcorn, so it's like a mixed breed. Hey, Japan, look here, Japan. Would you want to taste something? Is that good? That was delicious, wasn't it?
Kentucky mixed breed hybrid
champion
popcorn. Nothing like it in the whole world.
Get the way, Prince.
Diamonds and pearls.
Can't even taste that.
So enough of the acoustic crap, okay? Let's rock and roll. It's so easy!
Come on down.
let's rock and roll!
I don't know.
no problem.
Where's Todd? Somebody needs to.
It was the lights.
Scorpions.
Does it hurt?
Scorpions.
Now it's time to kick back.
See ya.
I'd like to thank the fans in Japan, the ones that we've gotten so far. We've gotten a lot of fan mail from there, and from what I can tell by reading the letters, very dedicated rock and roll fans. And we're just really looking forward to coming in and partying with you guys.
I'd just like to tell everyone in Japan to get ready to rock, because Roxy Blue will be coming to a town near you.
I'd like to tell everybody in Japan that totally looking forward to going to Japan. I mean, everybody says that Japan rocks harder than anywhere. And if they do, I've got to have a piece of it. I love the rock and roll, and I want to see if you can, hang with the boys, because we're ready to rock. I mean, we're ready to throw down. We're ready to, just get down. Drink lots of, sake. Because, y'all gave us sake gifts tonight. Let's get trashed and rock and roll, man. Let's have a good time. And let's smoke. Together.
For all you people in Japan, just get ready for some loud, very loud, energetic rock and roll. And be prepared to party hard.
just be our secret.